Hello everyone, I'm Wenbo Zhou. The title of our paper is Improving Local Search for Pseudo Boolean Optimization by Fragile Scoring Function and Deep Optimization. The authors include Wenbo Zhou, Yujiao Zhao, Yiyuan Wang, Shaowei Cai, Shimao Wang, Xinyu Wang, and Minghao Yin. This work is carried out by Northeast Normal University, Jilin University, Chinese Academy of Sciences, and the University of Chinese Academy of Sciences. I would introduce our work from the following aspects, including preliminaries, related work, two-level selection strategy, deep OPT PBO algorithm, experiments, and conclusion. Let's see what pseudo Boolean optimization is. Since a nonlinear pseudo Boolean constraint can be translated into an equivalent set of linear PB constraints, we only discuss linear PB constraints here. A linear constraint is defined over a finite set of Boolean variables. A linear PB constraint is a 0-1 integer inequality, where ai and b are integer constants, li are literals. A pseudo Boolean optimization problem consists of a PB formula f and an objective function O. A PB formula is a conjunction of PB constraints, where CP is a PB constraint. An objective function is the sum of CI times LI, where CI is an integer constant. The PBO problem aims to obtain a feasible solution for f with the minimum objective value. Constraint weighting techniques have usually been used to guide the search process. Each PB constraint CP and an objective function O have the property of weighting, denoted as WCP and WO. The property of weighting works as follows. Weighting rules 1. At first, WO equals to 1 for an objective function O, and WCP equals to 1 for each PB constraint CP. Weighting rule 2. For each unsatisfied constraint CP, WCP equals to CP at 1. Weighting rule 3. If the current objective value is better than the current best found value of objective function during the search process so far, and the formula is satisfied, then WO equals to WO at 1. If a PB constraint CP is unsatisfied, the penalty of CP is defined as WCP times BP minus the sum of API times LPI. For the objective function O, the penalty of O is defined as WO times the sum of CI times RI. As a core guidance for the search process, scoring functions play an important role in local search algorithms, which measures the benefits of a candidate variable. For Boolean variable XI, the hard score and the objective score are the decrease of the total penalty of unsatisfied PB constraints and the objective function caused by flipping xi. The score of a variable xi is defined as score xi equals to h score xi at o score xi. Remark that after flipping some variables during the search process, the corresponding score values should be updated accordingly. Solvers for PBO can be divided into complete and incomplete solvers. Up to now, many complete PBO solvers have been proposed, such as Set4J, OpenWBO, NAPS, Rounding Set, ISCard, ISLP, Hybrid, and PBO-IHS. Compared to complete PBO solvers, there are relatively fewer incomplete solvers on PBO. The reason may be that PBO is more complicated than SET, and how to find a suitable variable to flip is still difficult. They proposed a novel local search algorithm called LSPPO. Besides, for some special cases of PPO, such as NK landscapes and mask keyset, a new perturbation strategy called VIGBP was proposed. According to the literature, the current best incomplete algorithm for PPO is the LSPPO. In our algorithm, we consider the sum of H-score and O-score as the primary scoring function, which is the same method as LSPPO. According to our preliminary experiments, 9% candidate variable on average have the same largest score value during the search. To address the issue about tie-breaking in the primary scoring function, previous work used the age information of variables as the secondary scoring function, where age is defined as the number of stamps since the last time it is flipped. However, the experimental results show that the use of only age cannot effectively guide the search process. Thus, to further choose a variable among this variable with the same best score value, we design a novel fragile scoring function denoted as HHScore. For a PB constraint CP, GAPCP is used to denote the satisfied threshold of CP. Based on the satisfied threshold of PB constraints, we define a fragile satisfied PB constraint in the following. For a satisfied PB constraint CP, the CP is a fragile satisfied PB constraint if and only if set LCP is less than GAPCP. On the one hand, if a satisfied PB constraint CP is fragile, we think that flipping any variable in this PB constraint would probably make this constraint become unsatisfied. On the other hand, if a satisfied PB constraint is not fragile, we think that this PB constraint is solid, which means that flipping any true literal in CP would not make CP become unsatisfied with a high probability. To maintain the information of fragile for each literal during the search process, we define inner as below. Suppose that a Boolean variable SI whose literal LI appears in some PB constraints and the coefficient of LI in CP is API. The value of inner XI CP is calculated as follows. The value of inner XI CP is subject to three distinct factors, including the state of CP, the value of LI, and the coefficient of LI. To make the readers easily understand the above definition too, we list all the situations corresponding to different inner values in a graphical explanation way. The full figure can be found in our paper. Considering all the PB constraints in which variable X literal appears, the proposed fragile scoring function HHScore of variable X is defined as below. Combining the respective advantages of score and HHScore, we propose a two-level selection strategy as follows. In addition, experiments show that the trigger fraction of using HHScore at least once for all the tested instances is about 99.6%. In flipping rule, flip a variable xi with the biggest score value. Breaking test by preferring the one with the biggest HHScore. Further tests are broken randomly. Recently, a general perturbation mechanism called deep optimization has been proposed by Chen, which can deeply probe some regions based on locked and unlocked optimizations, and then convert to a new solution quickly. According to this general framework, we propose a new deep optimization approach, deep OPT for PBO. The pseudo code of our proposed deep OPT is reported in algorithm 1. We use the unset alpha function to denote the set of unsatisfied PB constraints and an assignment alpha. At first, the algorithm used unsatisfied and satisfied to store unsatisfied and satisfied PB constraints under a perturbation initialization assignment, respectively, line 1. Afterward, a candidate variable set candSet is initialized to an empty set, line 2, which stores all unlocked variables in the following search. In the first phase, we flip several variables to achieve the purpose of early preparation. There are two XSet conditions in this phase. The first one is that the size of candSet is larger than gam times n, where n is the number of variables, line 3. Whereas, the second one is that the number of unsatisfied constraints under the current assignment is larger than max hard, line 15. At each iteration, if unsatisfied is not empty, the algorithm preferentially chooses a random unsatisfied PB constraint C from unsatisfied, lines 4 to 5, and put all variables of C into candSet, line 9. For each variable belongs to C, if X literal in C is true, it occurs with 50% probability to flip X, line 8. If the algorithm selects a random satisfied constraint C, the algorithm only adds all variables of C into candSet, line 14. In the second phase, the algorithm applies the search process to perturb the assessment alpha until the limit of iteration LOPT is reached, line 16. The algorithm employs the BMS strategy in the process of selecting a candidate variable, randomly choosing the size of candSet divided by two variables to compose a candidate set. Afterward, the algorithm flips a variable X among a candidate set based on the flipping rule, lines 17 to 18. The deep OPT PBO is mainly divided into the initialization and search phases. During the search, whenever a better feasible assignment is obtained, alpha star and OBJ star are updated accordingly, line 12. After each inner loop, the algorithm uses the restart VAR function to restart a current assignment, line 32. Finally, the algorithm returns alpha star and OBJ star when reaching a time limit. The algorithm uses good set to store variables whose score is larger than 0, line 15. If good set is not empty, the algorithm flips a candidate variable based on the proposed flipping rule, line 16 to 18. Otherwise, it means that the algorithm triumphs into local optimum. The algorithm used the modified weighting rule 2 and weighting rule 3 to update the corresponding weight value, lines 20 to 21. The algorithm judges whether to call the deep OPT method and each call times means then iteration, line 24. If the size of unsat alpha is not larger than mean hard, the algorithm calls the deep OPT method with a 50% probability, line 27. Otherwise, if alpha star is not empty, the algorithm will use alpha star as a perturbation initialization assignment, and then employ the deep OPT method, lines 28 to 30. Here, unhard is used to denote the number of unsatisfied PB constraints. Stamp OPT records the non-improvement stamps after the initialization phase or the last deep OPT operation. Cough is used to control the frequency of using the deep OPT method. The pseudo code of sample flip is outlined in algorithm 3. In the beginning, if there are no unsatisfied constraints, the algorithm selects and flips a random variable X with all score X larger than 0. The first sampling method is to select a random unsatisfied constraint C. len file. If the size of unsigned alpha is larger than bit, then the algorithm activates the second sampling method, namely adding bit unsatisfied constraints into CSite. Lines 7 to 10. In the face of variable flipping, if C is a unit clause, the algorithm flips only variable X in C, lines 11 to 12. If C is a binary clause, the algorithm tries to find two pairs of variables, x1, xi, and x2, xj, with the largest score t value, lines 14 to 15. If there exists a positive flipping operation among these two pairs, the algorithm flips a pair with the better score t value, lines 16 to 19. Otherwise, the algorithm still flips the only one variables among x1 and x2 based on the flipping rule, lines 20 to 21. In the subsequent process, the algorithm will depend on the value of parameter bit to collect some samples from CSite or C into VSite, lines 23 to 27. At last, the algorithm selects and then flips the best variable x from VSite, lines 28 to 29. By increasing the weight of unsatisfied constraints, we can accurately guide the search process toward more efficient directions. In each iteration of the inner loop, if good site is empty, the visited time of each unsatisfied constraint will be increased by 1. For an unsatisfied constraint CP, when its visited times are larger than BP divided by COF CP, the value of WCP will be increased by 1, and the value of its visited times is reset to 0. The second adopted technique is the restart strategy. Under current assignment alpha, we can change the original value of each variable with a certain probability, namely from 1 to 0 or from 0 to 1. According to the frequency of using the proposed restart strategy, we propose two versions of deep OPT PBO, resulting in version 1 and version 2. In detail, version 1 doesn't use the restart strategy. Version 2 is run for half of the computation time given to the algorithm with the restart strategy, while the second half of the available computation time of version 2 is given to the algorithm without the restart strategy. The proposed algorithm are compared against three state-of-the-art PBO algorithms, including a local search algorithm RSPBO and two exact PBO solvers, namely Hybrid and PBO IHS. Although mixed integer programming solvers and mask set solvers can be directly applied to solving PBO, we mainly focus on evaluating the performance of specialized solvers for PBO. We considered 3,738 instances obtained from 3 application benchmarks and 4 standard benchmarks, 24 instances from the minimum width confidence band problem, 18 instances from the wireless sensor network optimization problem, 21 instances from the seating arrangement problem, 1,600 OPT small int instances from the most recent PB computation in 2016, the 0-1 integer linear programming optimization benchmark contains 267 instances from the mixed integer programming library MIPRIP 2017, 1,025 crafted combinatory instances are provided in the literature 30. The NAPSEC benchmark consists of a total of 783 instances. Our proposed algorithms are consistently superior on the MWCB benchmarks. For the WSNO benchmark, two proposed algorithms and LSPBO can obtain the same best solution values. Furthermore, LSPBO can find minimal average solution for 15 instances, while our proposed algorithm do it for only 6 instances. For the SAP benchmarks, our proposed algorithms are also superior. Table 5 gives a summary on all the benchmarks. According to the experimental results, DeepOPT PBO version 2 outperforms other algorithms in terms of obtaining more optimal solution values on PB 2016, MIPRIB, and Graft, except for the benchmark NIP, where PBO IHS has a better performance. To sum up, for three application benchmarks, PB 2016, MIPRIB, and Graft, our algorithm totally dominates all the competitors, whereas PBO IHS performs better than other PBO solvers for the NIP benchmark. To verify the effectiveness of the proposed strategies, we compare DeepOPT PBO version 1 with three alternative versions. The first version utilizes the H strategies instead of HHSCAR. The second version doesn't use the DeepOPT method. The third one doesn't employ the sample flip function. The results in Table 6 demonstrate that all proposed strategies are effective. Additionally, we evaluate the performance of all the solvers on 7 benchmarks using performance profile. As shown in Figure 2, the plot captures the probability of reaching a fixed quality in a time, at most a factor tau slower than the optimal algorithm. Specially, when tau equals 1, we obtain the probability that the algorithm is the fastest. Figure 2a demonstrates the superior performance of DeepOPT PBO version 1 on the first three application benchmarks. It can be observed that DeepOPT PBO version 1 has a higher probability of finding the optimal solution for each tau. In Figure 2b, LSPBO performs the best within a short time scale. However, DeepOPT PBO version 2 surpasses LSPBO around tau equals 6 and maintains its leadership consistently. In this paper, we propose a two-level selection strategy, a novel deep optimization strategy, and a sampling flipping method. Based on the above strategies and some other tricks, we develop two local search algorithms. Experiments show that the proposed algorithm significantly outperformed the state-of-the-art PBO algorithm. That's all. Thank you for your attention.